Now to news about ourselves. BBC World News Television is moving to a new newsroom home, a broadcasting house in the heart of central London. It begins with GMT in less than 40 minutes, but right now a special tour for you of the BBC's new international news headquarters is my colleague Lucy Hockings.
Welcome to Broadcasting House, home of BBC News here in central London. For the first time in the BBC's history, our network and global services in radio, television, online and news have been brought together.
Once we've all moved in, there will be 6,000 people working here. That's approximately 45% of all BBC News staff. So what is it that makes this building so special? Well, at its heart is the biggest newsroom in Europe, bringing together journalists from television, radio and online, broadcasting in 28 different languages. The vision behind the layout here is that all of these teams are connected so that when a story comes in, we're easily able to share video and audio and, most importantly, the breaking news as it unfolds. BBC have invested in all the latest technology, and it's here in our galleries and studios where you can see it in action. And here we are in Studio A, our virtual reality studio, where we have the ability to conjure up all sorts of computer-generated environments, like this abandoned warehouse. You might recognize this one. That's right, it's Jupiter's moon Ganymede. I've even got the ability to take you all the way to Washington and the White House. That's how it looks on air, but at the core of everything we do is our journalism. And to get a sense of how this building brings together the best of the BBC, you have to go a few floors up.
Well, let's go live now to Lucy, who joins us from New Broadcasting House. Lucy, what's the atmosphere there? What, 35 minutes before we go to air from the newsroom behind you?
It is indeed, Nick. Walking into the building today was so exciting. The newsroom is absolutely humming. You're right, in about 40 minutes' time, we go on air. BBC World News is relaunching with GMT and George Alagiah. This is something we've been looking forward to and planning for years. Where I am standing right now is on the mezzanine. This is the home to our planning team. But let me just give you a bit more of a tour of the newsroom that you can see here behind me. We affectionately call this whole area the pit, but this is actually the biggest newsroom in Europe. And if you look across there, you can see our team getting ready right now for GMT. You might even see Roz Atkins typing away there on his iPad. But this is also home to some of the radio teams and people that coordinate all the material that you send in from around the world. But let me point out something that people find interesting often when they come to the newsroom, and that's our arrivals board, that blackboard there with the writing on it. All the different feeds that are coming into the building and bits of content coming into us are on there. So when I went down to have a look at it more closely earlier, there were pictures coming in from the Kumbh, the biggest gathering on earth taking place in India. We had some new pictures from LA and the Golden Globe Awards. We also had an audio piece from Mali from our correspondent there. And of course, as I mentioned, all the breaking news coming in on that arrivals board as well. What is remarkable though, Nick, as I mentioned in the piece, all of this talent, all of this expertise coming together in one building.
And Lucy, quickly, it's not just news in English.
It's certainly not. Let me take you five floors up if you can count. All the way up there is BBC World Service Radio and their 27 language services. They've also got some new studios up there, Nick, including a television studio and 40 minutes time as well. BBC Russian going on air up there. But I had a wander through an hour ago. So fascinating just listening into those editorial meetings taking place up there. The French and Africa team liaising closely with colleagues on Mali, for instance. BBC Urdu looking at the protests in Quetta. Weibo, the source of conversation, and the Chinese service as well, looking at pollution in Beijing. It's been really bad there the past couple of days. But what is incredible, Nick, they're just there, just a few floors up, and now we are here in the same building. It's an amazing time.
Great, Lucy. Looking forward to being there. Thanks for joining us live from Broadcasting House. And in GMT, they'll be live in Bamako with the BBC's Mark Doyle. I'll have the headlines shortly.